When we started, we had in mind one trailer, and we ended up with a process, a much longer process than we thought, which physically couldn't fit in a single trailer.
Trailer one is kind of like the dirty part of the process. Trailer two wasn't really supposed to exist. You know, on paper, we had to add trailer two later.
In 2019, an international team of researchers, engineers, and agribusiness experts launched the EU research project NOMAD, dedicated to build a mobile unit to process digestate. Trailer 2 was soon accomplished and set on a journey through Italy, Malta, and Greece to process digestate obtained from different types of biogas plants, where substrates like animal slurries, municipal wastewater, and crop waste were transformed to valuable fertilizers, irrigational water, and soil amenders. The main project partner constructing and building the lab on wheels, Leap Micro AD, is based in the UK. Rocky Yaman coordinates the Leap demonstration site where the prototype construction started in 2020.
When we started, we had in mind one trailer, and because of all the logistics of managing that material, having to get it down to a certain particle size, for the final processes, we had to have lots of intermediate steps. So it meant that we ended up with a process, a much longer process than we thought, which physically couldn't fit in a single trailer.
So a decision was made to build two different trailers. First, a lab on wheels was built, focusing on nutrient and grey water recovery, as well as antibiotic removal. Since 2022, this lab trailer has been tested in the field, performing the secondary process steps. To provide the fully autonomous and mobile NOMAD solution, Trailer 1, which prepares the digestate beforehand, is now being finalised and commissioned.
Trailer 1 is the first stage of the process. It basically takes the digestate, it macerates it, it will pasteurise it and filter it and get it ready for Trailer 2. So it's a key part of the process.
Both trailers were created in the Leap workshop in Wiltshire, southwest UK. Guy Blanche is the main development engineer.
Trailer one is the dirty part of the process, if you like. We're separating the solids from the liquid fraction. And in that process as well, we're doing some pasteurisation, which is for removing the pathogens and to sterilise the digestate material that comes in.
We're using a lot of stainless steel pipes in trailer one, and the reason is because of the high temperatures that we're working at. If we use plastic pipes, they're just going to go soggy and melt. So if we're using stainless steel, then we have to perform a purging operation as we're welding. We pass gas through, and that keeps the inside of the weld clean. And the reason for that is to minimise the amount of bacteria that grows on the inside of the pipe.
Keeping the system free of pathogens is very important. Therefore, the digestate will run through a pasteurisation process that reaches 72 degrees Celsius. As a circular approach was at the heart of the project, the researchers included a heat recovery section using the waste heat of the engine for the pasteurisation step. This process was simulated with a combined heat and power system built by Leap Micro AD.
So we're here next to the CHP, which stands for combined heat and power. So the NOMAD process needs both of those things. It needs heat for the pasteurisation and it needs power for the pumps and the motors and what have you. So what we're doing is recovering all of the heat from the engine. And we're simulating the lorry engine rather than using the engine on the truck. And we're taking that heat and we're passing it through into trailer one for the pasteurisation process.
To minimise volatile odours, the researchers also added a washing system to the scrubber unit.
What we're doing is washing this air with cold water. To try and capture those volatiles and keep them within the liquid fraction.
Right now, the different processes are being checked using water and cardboard. Once the trailer one has passed the testing phase, it will be put on a live test in the UK. On pilot scale, the trailer processes up to 5 tons of digestate sludge, resulting in solid and liquid streams, which are then processed by trailer two.
Truck one will be tested in the UK, and it will be tested using food waste digestate. We actually have already started to fundraise to develop both trailers further and test them, probably in the UK initially, but also potentially in Greece.
The vision of the researchers: providing small-scale farms in rural areas of Europe and beyond with a high-tech, fully equipped mobile trailer to process waste of anaerobic digestion plants to generate organic fertilizer and recycled water.
We could provide NOMAD as a service to manage surplus digestate. We can also look at leasing models, so NOMAD as a unit or units could be leased out to either a collective of AD plants or a single AD plant, and in that way reduce the kind of upfront costs. So NOMAD can really play a role in helping us to expand what we're doing in this circular bioeconomy area, and this will be a key factor in helping us to change people's behaviour and perception of waste, I believe.